Hello everyone, this is Chhavi, and in the recently declared results of CAT, I achieved a 100 percentile. I would like to help you all and give you some tips about preparing for CAT, and you're listening to my interview on Delhi Knowledge Track. So, something about me, I have graduated from IIT Delhi in 2016, after which I started working with Opera Solutions as a business analyst. And while working, I think after 1 or 2 years, I thought that maybe a management degree would help me further in my career. And so I decided to give CAT in 2017. I basically started my preparation in around March, where I joined a coaching institute. And I used to only prepare on weekends because my weekdays were not very free due to the job. And on weekends, I used to try to give one mock every weekend or every other weekend in the initial few days. And then later on, I tried to develop on my strengths and I figured out my weaknesses and tried to cover them up. So the main strategy that I followed, I think, for CAT is first learning how to manage your time in the actual paper. So, I mean, the most important thing about CAT is that every single question has got equal number of marks. So any question that you think is taking more than average time, it's better to leave it. It's always better to leave a question and come back to it later so that you do not miss out on easy questions. So this is the one important time management strategy that I learned. Apart from this, while preparing for CAT, I think there's like no particular syllabus because it is an aptitude test. And for verbal and reading comprehension, it's generally recommended that you read a variety of books of different genres, etc. And I think for preparation for CAT, especially for verbal and for logical reasoning, the only most important thing that you can do is to do a lot of questions, practice a lot of questions from different platforms, from different coaching institutes, maybe a few different books. I did not use any books because I did not actually have time apart from weekends. So I just concentrated on whatever was done in the coaching classes. I did not even study the coaching classes modules. But whatever was done there, and then I kept on revising the different mocks that I had given, what questions I got wrong, how much, if I had spent a lot of time on some particular question, how I could have done it differently, or if that particular question type should be left. So in case one does not want to join a coaching institute, and one wants to prepare on their own, the most important thing there is your motivation. So that you should be very well motivated, that you spend all your spare moments into CAT preparation, because CAT requires a lot of time, because you need to practice a lot of questions again and again. And for that, there is also availability of different free mock tests online. If you search, there are multiple free mock tests. Mostly all the institutes allow one free mock test on their particular institute website. And there are old CAT papers as well, which you can do in a timed manner on your own. So for self-study, the only key thing is keeping yourself motivated, spending all your time properly, and actually doing a lot of tests and analyzing them. However, I would strongly suggest to at least enroll for one of the mock test series from any of the coaching institutes. Maybe a bit good one, so that there are a lot of people giving the mocks and you can assess yourself properly. So this year, the CAT question paper was similar to the last year's. The verbal ability and reading comprehension section was not very difficult, but was not very easy as well. The reading comprehensions were easy to read and easy to understand. But the questions that were there, the options were very, very close. So it was difficult to eliminate. Once you have eliminated two options, it was difficult to choose one in many questions. And the verbal ability section, which generally comes pretty difficult, which becomes difficult because of para-jumbles and odd burnout, that was of a very high difficulty level. I think I attempted 29 questions out of 34 in this section. The second section was logical reasoning and data interpretation. This particular section is like the make or break of CAT since the past few years. And in this section, the key is to first figure out which test you're going to attempt. Because once you start attempting a test, you give it at least 7 to 10 minutes. So earlier in the mocks, what I used to do, the mistake that I used to make was that I did not used to actually figure out which sets I have to do. So figuring that out is of prime importance. So I gave the initial 5 to 7 minutes in figuring out what sets I'll be doing, and then attempting them in that order. So that helped me. I mean, that helped me in a lot of mocks. And this, I think I did around 23 questions out of 32 in this section. However, an attempt of even 16, 17 questions was very good in this section this year. Then coming to the last section of quantitative ability, this section was pretty easy, I think. It was easier than last year or like last few years. And this section should have been attempted. Like, it was highly possible to attempt all the questions. I attempted 32 out of 34. And this section could have been done in around 1 hour. It could have been easily done. If the basics were clear, there were no high formula type questions. And all that is required in quantitative is that your basics should be clear and that you have practiced a lot so that you can do the questions in a very short time. The level of maths that comes in quantitative ability is something I would say that can be done even by a 10th class student. I mean, it is not that straightforward. It's a bit tricky. But the concepts that are involved are generally often only class 10. So that is why I said that it is not required to remember all the different formulae or very difficult or complicated formulae. It is, you should only remember the basic formulae and know your way how to apply them, etc. So that is the key here. It is not like people who are from non-maths background should be very scared of this section. I don't know math. I have not done math in past 5-6 years. It's not like that. It's just simple math, just a bit trickier. You need to apply your brains everywhere in every question. Just keep your basics clear and practice a lot of questions. Now, I would like to guide you on how to manage your time during your preparation. So when I started in March, I used to only give weekends study. However, around like August 10th or September, I started getting up early and started trying to give one more extra hour to my study before my office hours. So that helped me in a way that I could revise. But I think even weekends are sufficient if you are focused enough and you spend at least 7 to 8 hours on Saturday and Sunday individually. A bit about how CAT releases its forms, etc. So I think CAT notification comes around July end, and the deadline to fill the application is around in September starting or August end. The final admit card is out by October end, and the exam is generally in November end or December start. And after that, the results are generally announced in January 1st or 2nd week. Post that, everyone gets a shortlist call from different IIMs. Different IIMs have got their own criteria of shortlisting students. And once that happens, every IIM has, again, a different criteria of selecting students. So that might include a GED, that might include a written ability test, and generally include the personal interview as well. So overall, I would like to say that CAT is an aptitude exam and that you do not need to have very strong, or you do not need to have taken maths in your final, in your 11th and 12th for that. It is all about basics. You need to have your basics clear and you need to practice a lot. It can be done even while you are doing a job. Because while doing a job also, if you study overall the week, however you distribute your time, overall, if you study for 15 to 16 hours and give a mock test, that should be sufficient. I hope my tips would help you in your preparation for CAT. In case you have any questions, you can either comment on this video or you can search me on Quora and ask me there. And keep watching Delhi Knowledge Track and please subscribe. Thank you.